food's not small.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
For choosing to watch the video, and in this one we are perch fishing again, and I hope you're looking forward to getting out there to catch some big perch yourself. Just so look forward to this time of year. It's starting to get cold and it definitely feels like it's time to grab the lure rod and get out there and do some perch fishing. So if you follow my fishing, you know a lot of it's done on limited time. Quite often I either choose dawn or dusk. That is because dawn and dusk fits around my life quite well. I'm often doing things through the middle of the day, whether it's with the family or work. So quite often for me, I'm left having to choose between fishing dawn or dusk, which is a great time to fish. You know, we know that perch like low light levels. So you're going to join me on a series of sessions to find out which is better, dawn or dusk. Let's find out. Might have had a hit then. So let's try it again. Nice deep water here. Been a very tricky dark, very tricky morning so far. Literally been fishing about an hour and not a touch. Water's quite coloured. So I'm fishing lures that have got a strong silhouette. So it's not necessarily bright, either very dark or very light, in fact, just to try and create that silhouette. But nothing, literally nothing, not even a jackpike. Oh, there we go, just as I said it. Look at that, taut that one onto the hook. You're just about swimming in, I think. Yes, he's a nice fish actually. Whoop. There we are, nice little perch on the squirrely. Lovely. Can see now I'm fishing slow, really slow, and that's how I picked up that last fish. I've been moving around the river at a reasonable pace, trying to find these fish this morning, and here came into this one, had a knock, a definite knock. You know, I was still fishing at a reasonable pace, and so I slowed everything down to investigate where I'd had that hit and had a perch. So again, with this Flotex, it's great for that. You know, I can move around the river, try and find them. Once I found them, I can slow down and try and pick them off. So there we are. That's the first dawn session that I'm doing as part of this video, and yeah, it didn't go great. So a couple of hours, all I had is one small perch, had a follow from something half decent, but in my comparison of dawn and dusk, that dawn wasn't great. On my next sessions, I was actually doing a video for Corum for the new Gonk lures. I'd struggled at dawn, but then this had happened at dusk. As you can probably tell, it's right on dusk now. The light levels are just dropping, and I think this is probably my best chance of a decent perch. And fortunately, we did manage to get one with the gonks for the cameras. And this is why I like dusk. You know, struggled at dawn, come out at dusk, you can see how dark it is. I mean, it's pitch black out here. And look at him. Stunning, stunning fish. You know, I do prefer dusk. I do tend to get better results. I'd better get off home. It's getting a bit dark, to say the least. If you want to see the full Coram Gonk video, there's a link in the description and on screen now. Let me just take you through the lures I've been using in this video. It's a couple of different types of new lures that have come out on the market from Coram. They're made of the Flotex material, so that is the material that we've come to know and love that are on the squirms and the reggies, you know, so these fish really well Ned Rig style. But in actual fact, the difference with these new lures is that, you know, there's the gonk, for example, and you can see whilst it's made of that Flotex material, it's more like a shad, and that's the large version, that's the 9 centimetre version, and it's got a paddle tail look. And that means that you can fish it in the water like a shad, and you can then drop it down onto the deck and fish it like a Ned Rig as well. So that's really nice. And yeah, so I'm using those. As I say, that's the 9 centimetre version in rear whale, and it comes in a whole bunch of different colours. And there is a 6 centimetre version that's much, much smaller in a variety of colours. You know, all the ones we've come to know and love, you know, like Dark Lord and Silverfish and Real Ale and Motor Oil. And there's a couple of new colours that have just come in, like Bruiser and Lobworm, that you've definitely got to check out. So anyway, those are the gonks. I'm using those. I'm also using these. These are called the Squirlies, and they've got a curly tail, as you can see. So they're almost like a squirm, but with a curly tail, which again means that you can fish them up in the water and drop them down onto the deck. So it's kind of like, you know, you can use them for searching and finesse fishing. So yeah, I'm excited to be using these, and it's what I've been using the last few weeks, just sort of like trying them out. And yeah, they've been really good. I'm fishing both lures in a range of different ways. I think these curly tails are fantastic on a drop shot. I think they look really, really good, the squirlies on a drop shot. I'm also just fishing them on straight jig heads, and I'm also fishing them on cheb rigs. So I'm sort of chopping and changing a little bit, but it's mainly cheb rigs and drop shot for the squirlies. To be honest, the gonks, I'm just using them with straight jig heads. Either a 5 gram jig head or a 3 gram jig head, usually, if I can get away with it. Back out again at first light, another dawn session. It's hit it. Yeah, it's a pike. Wallop, that hit it hard. Oof. Wow. Absolutely nailed it, that did. Absolutely nailed it. Right down there, walloped it. There we go. Another pike. You can see, absolutely nailed that squirrely there. Glad I got the trace on. Let's get him back in. Hopefully we will get that perch. Let me show you something here. Look, I've made up my own traces. You can see there. And I feel like you've got to do that. If you've got pike in your section, which you've seen, I've picked up a couple of pike here. I'm using a trace that I've made up myself, and I always make them out of really light wire. This wire is only 10 pound breaking strain. I don't think it puts the perch off, and it just makes sure that we're thinking about fish care and that we're not leaving any tackle in fish. So I want to show you how I make up these traces. I'll take you through the bits and pieces. I use the Esox soft strand in 10 pound breaking strain. You know, if I pull it off there, you'll hardly be able to see it. It is so fine, and of course that's what we want when we're targeting the perch. So the first thing to do is to take your wire and pull off a good sort of like foot or so of that. Where you're going to cut this wire, just heat it up. I've got a lighter here. Just heat it up over the flame slightly. What that's going to do, that's going to stop it from fraying when I cut the wire. So there we go. When you're putting on your components, it needs to be done in a certain way. I'm going to have to get closer to show you this because it is quite fine. What you need to do is double over the wire like so. Let's put the clip on first. So I don't know if you can see it, but there's the clip. It's a tiny little clip with a swivel on it. What we need to do is we need to get that loop and we need to push it through the swivel. Okay, so that you've got the loop coming through the swivel like that. Then you're going to push it through all the way. If I get my hands out of the way, it looks something like that. And then with that loop, we want to push the component through the loop, if that makes sense. And then we're going to pull it tight. It's going to be a bit difficult for you to see what I mean, I think, but what you should end up with when you pull it tight like that is something like that. As I say, you've put the end of the loop through the ring of the swivel there. With the loop, you've pushed the rest of the clip and the component through and then pulled it tight to create something like that. Now, straight away, without any knots or any twisting, you should be able to feel that that is holding quite firm. The tag end that's there, you can heat that up. Like so, and then all I do is twist it. So I'll secure my forceps onto the tag end like that, and then I'll just sort of twist it round like that. I know there are tools to do this in a much neater way, I think, but this is all that I do. I take the forceps off and I'll trim it all up, and you'll be left with something like that. If you can see, I've now got the clip that, and I've got a twisted section of wire at the bottom. And if you pull that, that really is holding quite firm. And then you just need to repeat it down the other end with the barrel swivel. Again, it's a very, very tiny little swivel that I'm using. All the components are small. What you can do is I sometimes do this. Can you see there? I've got a section of shrink tube that I've just sort of put over the twist there. I don't think that's always essential. It does kind of stop it from unraveling. You might struggle to find shrink tube that's as fine enough to actually grip this wire. It is that fine. One tip is that when you heat the shrink tube up over the kettle, is to actually sort of grip the shrink tube with your forceps while you heat it up and squeeze. And that kind of just helps the shrink tube to grab onto the wire. I should have said that's about maybe a foot and a half. And that is a super fine wire trace and how I make them up when I'm perch fishing, but I know that there are pike present. So here we go, as you can probably tell, dusk. Been struggling at dawn a bit. You know, I've been having fish, but only small perch and pike. It's all about dusk, I'm sure it is. Hopefully we'll catch some perch just as the light's fading. Right, now, this swim keeps doing pike every time I come into it, but one of these days, I'm going to walk into it and I'm going to get a decent perch. I know I am. Hasn't happened yet. There you go. Told you. Literally, first chuck. What did I say? And there is no way that is a perch. Slammed it straight away. Might loosen that a bit too much. First chuck every time in this swim. Jesus, it's actually quite a good one, ain't it? Yeah, it's not small. Oh, Jesus Christ. Every time in this swim. Every bloody time. He slammed it, hasn't he? The net ready. Oh, Jesus Christ, it's quite a good one. It's not small. It's one of the bigger ones I've had from this section, eh? It feels like he's found a snag there. Let's keep him moving. Oh no, he's out. He was in a snag for a second there. Jesus. Quite like to see him. This one, he's giving me a right run around. He's quite a decent one. Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, got very light gear on here for this fish, really. Decent one. Jesus. I say it's pretty light here. I can't go too heavy on him. Bloody good fight. Oh, struggling a bit. I'm struggling. Oh. It's got the old switch ticking. Jesus Christ. Struggling to control him on this outfit, to be honest. Oh no. Oh, where is he? Is he there still? Or has he done me? I think he might have done me in a snag. If he has, I will be upset. Oh no, he's still there. And he's out again. Right. Might have to give him a little bit of force because this has got silly. There we go. Oof. Oh, he's a bit big for this setup. Oh, yeah, he's a decent one. Jesus Christ. Told you this swim every time. So, come out at dusk, and it's not what I'm after, but it's a pretty good fish for this section. Look at him. On a small outfit, gave me the right run around. Awesome pike, on a squirrely, spotted goby. Get him back and see if we can get that perch. Not as big as the last one. This swim holds so many pike. Surely it's got to have some perch in it. Thank God I've got the trace on. There's no way I would be landing these fish. Oh, he's actually a bit better than I thought. Hoping to get him in a bit quicker than the last one. There you go. Glad I got the trace on. Just got to try and find these perch. There we go. There's another one in quick succession. I'm going to get him straight back. Yeah, shows the importance of having a trace on that, doesn't it? He's a bit frisky, this one. Let's get him back. Unbelievably, I then had another one. The pike were just too active. So, there we go, as you can probably see. It's getting dark. That's dusk done. Very action-packed. You know, a few pike, no perch. So that's another dusk done. There. Straight retrieve every time. Look at that lovely little perch. Beautiful little perch. Let's get him back. Tell it's getting dark, and yeah, been fishing at dusk. Unfortunately, the GoPro cut out just as I hooked this one. He's not a monster, but he is quite a nice fish. He'll do me. Proving again that for me, it's all about dusk. On the squirrely, not a monster, but happy with him. That real whale colour again. You know, it's such a good colour. We'll get him back and see if we can get a bigger one before it gets dark. Okay, so we're approaching dusk. I'm just about to go down the river. I do appreciate that it looks like I'm doing a lot of dusks and not many dawns. But this morning I did go out, didn't catch anything, just a couple of wasps, nothing really to share there. So I'm going to go down the river now. At dusk, hopefully we'll get a fish. This time I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm going to fling around some little creature baits on light jig heads, see if we can locate some of those big perch. Feels like it could be a perch, and it is a perch. Just taking it easy. Oh, it's good. Oh, it's good. Oh, he's in. Told you it's all about dusk, because look at him. It's the best time of day. The light levels are dropping. £3.3. Stunning, stunning perch. Gonna get him back. So there we go, that concludes the video. As you've probably guessed, you know, I do prefer dusk. But, you know, it's not great for filming, is it? You're losing the light the whole time. So, you know, dawn would be better for that. But I have had most of my success in the final moments. You know, sometimes I've been out all day and nothing's really happened until those light levels drop. And so, yeah, if I had to choose between the two, I'd definitely choose to go fishing for perch at dusk. Sorry about this. I forgot to say in the outro, please let me know in the comments, which do you prefer, dawn or dusk? Or maybe it's a completely different time of day altogether, you know, or maybe there isn't a pattern. But let me know which you prefer, dawn or dusk, in the comments. That way we can all look at comments and build a general idea of what people are thinking. Back to the outro. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then please remember to like and subscribe and all that stuff. As we go into autumn, if you've started to get out there with the lure rod, I hope you have a great perch season. Definitely, you know, we're coming into late October now. The temperatures are dropping and, you know, it can be tricky in October. To be honest, I have found it a little bit tricky. I do think as we go into November and December, the perch fishing's gonna get even better and I can't wait. But that's it for now. I'll see you in the next video. Until then, look after yourselves and be lucky. Look at this old smiler. Hello, fella. Beaky. What character?